The name Australopithecus Bahr el Ghazali was given because the jaw and teeth remains were first discovered in Bahr el Ghazal in Chad, Central Africa in 1995 by a Franco-Chadian team led by palaeontologist Michel Brunet. The type specimen is an adult lower jaw which included a lower second incisor, both lower canines and all four premolars. Brunet nicknamed the specimen Abel after his deceased colleague Abel Brillanceau. Fossils are dated to about 3.6 million years old using beryllium-based radiometric dating published in 2008. A total of four jaw fragment fossils were discovered, of which three of the four known fossils were found as part of the 1995-1996 expedition. A fourth fossil mandibular fragment with two teeth was discovered in 2000, a few kilometers south of the earlier site. These remains are the first from the genus Australopithecus to be discovered outside of southern and eastern Africa. This enlarges the known geographic range of these hominins. Studies suggested that this species lived in a lakeside environment surrounded by forests, wooded savanna, and open grassy patches. Based on the fossil's age, many paleoanthropologists think the bones belonged to Australopithecus afarensis. But the specimen was found more than 1,500 miles farther west than any other Australopithecus afarensis bones, and subtle difference in the size and shape of the fossils led the discoverers to conclude they had found a new species. As to the species' place in the evolutionary tree, more finds are needed in order to ascertain where this species fits on the human family tree. Its relationship to other Australopithecines is debated, but many scientists believe it may be closely related to Australopithecus afarensis, with whom it shares numerous characteristics. Others believe it is a subspecies of Australopithecus afarensis. However, controversy continues as this is the only Australopithecine fossil found in Central Africa. Lack of skeletal remains makes it difficult to describe the species build, and lack of cranial remains makes cranial capacity estimates difficult. But the similarities in jaw and teeth features to other Australopithecines suggest the brain would be in the same range of 400 to 550 cubic centimeters as other species in the genus. With just jaws and teeth, there's not too much scientists can say about what Australopithecus Bahr el Ghazali looked like or how it lived its life. But fortunately, diet is something that can be gleaned from these fossils. Tooth enamel is of a similar thickness to Australopithecus afarensis, and as Australopithecus Bahr el Ghazali appears to have lived in a mosaic of open and wooded biomes near a river, certain assumptions were made before proper analysis, and that is that it ate mostly greens. One way of knowing what one ate was analyzing the teeth's chemistry. This is possible because the carbon found in plants comes in two versions, or isotopes, called C3 and C4. Trees and other forest plants are rich in C3, while grasses, sedges, and other grassland plants have an abundance of C4. When an animal eats these plants, or eats other animals that eat these plants, the different carbon isotopes get incorporated into the individual's teeth, serving as a record of what it once ate. After the analysis, researchers came to a conclusion that the individuals of this species mainly ate C4 plants, probably grasses and sedges. And like modern baboons that live on savannas, the hominid probably ate different parts of these plants, including underground tubers and bulbs. This diet is not surprising given the type of habitats the species lived in. This kind of diet means that by 3.5 million years ago, hominins were probably already broad generalists, capable of eating a variety of foods depending on what was locally available. Being a food generalist may have allowed Australopithecus Bahr el Ghazali to explore new environments and leave behind the forests that earlier hominids, such as Ardipithecus ramidus and their ancestors, resided in. And that is all that we have for you on Australopithecus Bahr el Ghazali. Thanks for watching, and do let us know what you thought of it in the comments section down below. For more videos on human evolution, check our channel out, and please do not forget to support us by liking our videos and subscribing to the channel. Till then, this is Halabella, and see you soon in our next video.